Hi friends, in this video I'm going to talk about why we should not buy IPOs like Paytm and Zomato. Most of you are not going to like what I have to say about IPOs, as I have done one earlier video about the prospects of not investing in IPOs. Turns out to be applicable in this case as well. So now let's understand a bit about the dynamics that goes behind making an IPO. What are IPOs? So basically, IPOs are nothing but companies that are looking to exit some of their stake and sell it to some other investor, or they're looking to raise more money to expand. So when they raise an IPO, they actually file something called a draft red herring prospectus, right? It's also called as a DRHP, which is again filed with our regulator, who's also called as Securities Exchange Bureau of India. So most of these IPOs, they don't make a profit, be it Paytm, be it Zomato, and also a few other IPOs that are getting listed. They're priced at a very high price, and also again they don't make any profit. Now you might ask, these promoters, again they come on TVs and lot of celebrities again talking about this particular stock, so why not buy the IPO stock on the day of its listing and make some profit? So here are three reasons I'm going to tell you, and these three reasons will again also convince you why you should stay away from IPOs in general. Number one, IPOs are launched only during market tops. Look at every market cycle, be it 2000, 2007, and even 2021. See when the IPO boom is coming. Most IPOs get listed when the market is positive, and also when there is a lot of liquidity. I'll explain to you in a minute what this means. Look around you, look around your friends. How many of them are into trading in the stock markets, especially after the lockdown? I bet most of them would actually be trading in the stock markets right now, thinking of making quick money because the market has risen drastically in the last 1 year. Believing this now every day when the index is setting new records, now these promoters and merchant bankers who have a vested interest on these IPO stocks, they wanted to monetize on this opportunity when the market is doing good. And how do they do that? They do that by dumping the stocks on us, right? Second reason is this: there are many attractive stocks which don't deserve to get attention, right? So there are almost close to, 5,000 to 7,000 stocks that are again getting traded in Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchanges. And most investors, they don't pay attention beyond the Nifty 50 or even mid-cap stocks. There are many stocks that are available that are reasonably priced, where the investor can make good returns with a margin of safety. To make good returns by making these investments. And number three is that there is a lot of hype around it, right? So when a stock is going to get listed, there is a lot of promotion that goes on, roadshows, presentations, and also like celebrity endorsements, and also again a lot of forwards in WhatsApp groups, blogs, and even a lot of PR to tell a story. So usually people tell a story, the promoter tells a story, and also the bankers tell a story, the celebrities, TV anchors, who even might not have a vested interest in the stock, might even tell a story. And the story will be convincing and believable in a way that as retail investors, they will lure us into get the subscription, right? Even our brokers, if you are having Zerodha or any other trading account. So you get a lot of reminders asking for your buy-in to commit buying a certain number of IPO shares before they are going to get listed on the listing day. Right. So now all of this, what happens is I realized that in the stock market journey, the single most reason why people make lose money is due to one reason called greed. Right. Let me ask you an honest question. Right. Before we even decide whether to invest in IPO stocks like Paytm or Zomato, how many of you have read even 15 to 20 pages of a draft red herring prospectus of these companies, which includes their financial statements? Right? Most of them would not even have known that such a document exists, or would have again read it. As investors, it's more important to understand what's the financial portion of the company, and also understand the real intent why the promoter and other anchor investors are looking to exit during this opportune times. If you are able to understand this particular logic, then you are almost saved from buying an overvalued stock. Right? So we have seen this across all the cycles. Let's go back in time and understand what happened to Reliance Power's IPO. It was just hyped to an extent where again it's going to be the next big thing in 2007. So now almost the stock has crashed 90-95%, and people don't even talk about it. That's the fate of IPO investors. When the market is positive and touching all-time highs, that is the time to exercise caution. When the market is touching all-time highs, that is the time to exercise caution. So I would warn all of you to stay away from IPOs. And if you are still keen on buying the IPOs, I would again still insist on waiting for a period of 1 year or 1.5 years, and the stock price would automatically cool off. So whether they are launching at $4 billion or $2 billion, it's not interesting for us, right? We are getting into stock markets for one single reason, to create wealth. And the valuation will be one key factor that will determine our exit multiple. With this note, I summarize: all IPOs, they come only during market tops and when the market is filled with euphoria and optimism. Number two, understand the promoters and existing investors' motive, why they are looking for an exit during this opportune time. Number three, study the company in detail, understand the financials of the company, and then if they are attractively priced and if you see there is value in it, buy the IPO. Number four, these IPOs, they all are exorbitantly overpriced, and almost all the growth is captured by the existing private investors who got in early and now they are looking to exit the overvalued stock on us. Right? So if this four reasons don't convince you, then I'm sorry, I can't stop you from again buying an IPO stock. And I'm not a SEBI registered investment advisor, so please consult your financial advisor before taking any financial decisions. I hope you enjoyed liking this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel and also feel free to share it with your friends. Thank you so much.